Morning, students. Welcome to math class. Last class, I explained the distance between the two points. Now, we'll explain the section form. A is one point, any one point. B is another point. AB is a line segment. Here is one point is there. This is point P. This point P divides this line into two parts. What are the AB one part, PB one part. Now dividing this two parts, not the equal parts, any parts. Here to here distance, here to here distance, not equal. Sometimes equal, sometimes not equal. But here we are assuming P is a between A and B. This P point is divides this line segment into two parts. That this is the length m units, this is n. Now, A point is assuming x1 comma y1. This point B is assuming x2 comma y2. P divides two parts, that is PA. Another part is P. This ratio PA is PB or AB is PB. That is m is n. Plus here P is in between A comma B. That's why this is divides into internally. This P point is divides like segment AB into internal. Now internal P point we have to find. P divides the line segment AB in M is M. Then P point D, the P is assuming X comma. Proof is there in the lower section. We are going to prove that directly formula explain that P point P X comma Y is M into X2, MX2 plus N into X1, NX1 by M plus N. Comma. Next, this is the X coordinate space. Y coordinate. M into Y2. M Y2 plus N into Y. N Y1 divided by M plus N. Here P is internal is there between A comma B. That's why this P is divides AB in internal B. Ratio is M is N ratio. If P is divided the line segment AB, M is N, then P coordinates part by MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N, M by 2 plus N by 1 by M plus N. That means P is this is the line. This one. This point divides this line segment into two parts. Suppose that P is externally. Externally means here is A is there. Here is B. This point is X1 comma Y. This point is X2 comma Y. X2 comma Y. Now, if you can extension of this line, here is one Q. This point divides this line segment AB into two parts. What are the two parts? Here to here distance totally m units. This is the n units. Q to A. Q to B. This Q is externally there. That's why Q divides the line segment in externally M is to M. Then Q point is then MX2 minus NX1. Here I have taken by M minus N. Comma. M into Y2, M Y2. Minus n y by m minus. What is the difference between these two is both are section formulas. Both are fitted. But this is divides this line MHTN internally. This one is divides Q point in AB line in externally. That's why here we have to take negative that. Suppose this point P divides the line segment in two equal parts. Suppose P, this is the same point. equal means year to year distance. M means 1 unit. This is also 1 unit. Same. Suppose this is a 2 units. This is also 2 units. Same distance. Then automatically this point will be, it is the midpoint of line equation B. This P is the midpoint of. Midpoint means this P divides this line segment two equal parts. Equal can divide. Year to year distance, year to year distance, 1 unit or 2 units. Same distance. Then automatically this P is the midpoint. Same year, young place, 1 unit of students formula, young place also. But automatically P is M means 1 into x, same points. This is x1 by 1, this is x2 by 1. Now, x1 by 1, x2 by 2, M plus 1 subscript, 1 into x2 plus 1 into x1 by M plus and 1 plus. M into y, M means y1, y2 plus M means 1, y1 by M plus and 1 plus. Therefore, this is 1x2 plus n, 1x1, this can be written as x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. This is the midpoint formula. If you can do points, it can, midpoint of the formula is the sum of the two x coordinates by number of terms. Here x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Divides this line segment into two equal parts. Two equal parts means here it divides in two equal parts. Equally divides. This is one, this is one. And this is two. Then this P is the midpoint of AB. Whenever we can divide equally, then this P is equally two parts. Then this P is equally.
Just to be up here. Once again, repeat.
Once again, I will repeat that. Here is, can explain that previously, different distance between the two points we reached the last class. Now I will explain section formula. Section is dividing one line segment, any one point divides some parts, two parts. Here is, I have explained only two parts, three parts also is there. Now, if you get this point P, is divides this AB line segment into two parts. This path length is M, this path length is N. This is the ratio, M is to N ratio. Then this P coordinates X, Y. This proof is there in lower section, but you have known it that P is X, Y. Then what is P formula is? P divides the line segment AB with M is to N ratio. Then this P point X coordinate formula is this M into x2, the second coordinate, x coordinate, plus n into x1 by m plus n. Then y coordinate, m into y2, plus n into y1 by m plus n. Here is in between a comma, that means this ratio is internally. Then here it's observed that this point is q. Suppose this is the AB line. AB line, this is the AB line segment. Extension of this AB line here is there. Here one point is there. This point is between A comma B is not there. Other side, any one side. P, yes, Q is externally there. That's why this Q is divided this line externally. This length is M units. That means A to Q length M units. P to Q length is M units. Then the Q point divides this line segment AB externally. So here exterior point outside of the AB line. Here is interior inside of the AB line. That is the difference. Now see here exterior, that means this length is totally M. Here is length N. That's why this line segment M minus N. That's why we have subtract that MX2, M into X2 minus N into X1. Here, where I take that minus is this line Q point is divides this line segment into externally exterior point. That's why you have to take this one negative. M X2 minus N X1 by M minus N. Y coordinate value M into Y2 minus N into Y1 by M minus N. Suppose the point is P is in between A comma B only. This P is interior point only. But if divides his life treatment to two equal parts, equally divides. Equally divides means A to B distance, AP, but PV, both are also same. This is 2 inches, this is also 2 inches. This is 3 inches, this is also 3 inches. That's like this P point is, why? If P point is divides equally, then the P point is midpoint of the client segment. That is the midpoint. Midpoint means same ratio, that is 1:1. Suppose 2 is there, 2/2, then that is also 1:1. That's why taking it is a midpoint, then 1:1 ratio. Formally, same formula. M plus 1 substitute n plus 1 substitute. X2 plus X1 by 1 plus 1. Y2 plus Y1 by 1 plus same this. Suppose one point is line segment trisector. Trisector means trace 3. In a line segment AB divides into 3 parts. Then trisecting points. Trisecting points means suppose this is the AB line. This line segment AB, this is X1 comma Y1. This is X2 comma Y1. X1 comma Y1, X2 comma Y1. Here is 2 points, is there 1P. Distance between this trisecting is 3 equal parts. Previously I explained that midpoint means 2 equal parts, but this trisector means 3 equal parts. That means A to P distance, P to Q distance, Q to B, B distance. Totally 1, 1, 1, or 2, 2, 2 units, or 3, 3 units. That means same equal. This is the trisector points. That means here is 2 points, there one is P, another one is Q. P point, suppose we can take P. P is a trisector point. P is distance A to P. P to P. A to P means what? 1 unit. P to B means what? This totally 2 units. That's why P point divides this AB line segment into 1:2 ratio. Because P is a trisector point. Here A to P distance 1 unit, P to B distance is 2 units. Suppose Q is also a trisector point, Q is also divides this line segment into, Q means here. Here clear how much that is 2 units, this one is 1. Q is also trisector point, this is the divides into 2:1. It's a trisector, if you can find the trisector points means the ratio of 1:2 and 2:1. Both the points also trisector of this line segment AB, because P is divided into 1:2 ratio, Q is divided into 2:1 ratio. That's why these 2 points also, P and Q also, both also trisector. We can find the trisector points means 2 also. Both also trisector. Because this one, P and Q, both this line segment into 3 parts. Totally A to P 1 part, P to B 2 parts. That's the total 3 parts. Next. Now another one. Centroid. Centroid means A term ABC is a triangle. Centroid points means median. A to B. That all intersecting of the E to B. Bisector points. That means here is bisecting. Here is the distance between A to B. Suppose this is P. This P is a divides 2 equal parts. 2 equal parts means PB. PA is equal. Here is Q. Q is divides this in 2 equal parts. This is also AQ equal to C. This is R. PR equal to R. That's why 2 equal parts divides this one. This is the medians of the any 2 medians intersecting on point, that is the centroid G. Centroid G formula, this is X1 comma Y1. This is X2 comma Y2. This is X3 comma Y2. Formula is centroid G equal X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3. Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3. Sum of the coordinates X coordinate by 3. y coordinates y. Now I will explain that CET questions that it will change. First one, one end of the diameter of a circle is -2,5 and the center of the circle, center of the circle is 2, -2. Then the other end of the diameter, end of it is option A 6,7. Option B -6,7. Option C -6,-7. Option D 6,-. Now, circle, this is the circle. Here is center of the circle is given 2, -1. Now this is the diameter. Diameter means a passing through the center, joining any two points on the circle. Any two points on a circle AB. This is the center. One end point is given -2,5. This one will have to find. This is assuming A,B. This point will have to find. Then automatically the center is midpoint of AB. Center is midpoint of AB. Midpoint formula is center C is midpoint of AB. C is midpoint of AB. Then C equal formula x1 + x2 / 2 y1 + y2. The center C is what? 2, -2. x1 + x2. This is -2 + a / 2. y1 + y2. 5 + b / 2. Equalizing 2 = -2 + a / 2. 2 × 2 = 4. -2 + a. -2 = 4 + 2 = 6. Okay. Next, -1 = 5 + b / 2. 2 × 1 - 2 = 5 + b. Plus 5 shift to the side, -5. -5 - 2 = -5. This is okay. Therefore, another end point is 6, -. Option C. Second one, find the distance between A 5, -3, that is 7, 3, and B on the x axis, whose axis I option A is 5, option B is 6, option C is root 6, option D is root 5. Here one point 7, 3 is there. Here is there, suppose 7, 3 point. B lies on the x-axis. B lies on the x-axis. That is, here opposite side is 11. That means here x coordinate is given. Y coordinate lies on the x-axis compulsory thing. Now we have to find out this distance. Distance between the two points. Then A is 7, 3, and B point is, according to given condition, 11, 3. A distance x2 - x1² + y2 - y1. This is x1 y1. This is x2 y2. Square root of x2 - x1, 11 - 7² y2 - y1 = 0 - 3². Square root of 7 - 4 is 7, 11 - 7 is 4² = 16. minus 3 whole square is 9. Square root of 20. That is 5 units. That is 5 units. Next, third one. Third one, you only do that. That is same previous method. This is x axis is given. Third problem is y axis. Here is the. So, over one. Fourth one. Find the ratio of the line joining 2, -4 and -3, 6 divided by the x axis. Okay, option A 2:3, option 2, option C -3:2, option D -2:2. Now we have 2 points, 2, -4, -3, 6. 2, -4 and -3, 6. 2, -4 means x is positive, y is negative, that means here is this. This is 0.2, -3. -3, 6. X is negative, here is this. -3, 6. Now, we have to find out this is divided into the x-axis. Maybe here or here. Sorry, x-axis means here. Now, this is the ratio we have to find. This is the P. Point divides the m is to n ratio. Then what is the m is to n? If we can divide into x-axis means compulsory point is small a comma 0. Because in x-axis, y coordinate is 0. X coordinate is anyone that. That's why this divides into two parts. That's why this P is this line segment AB in internally, then that P divides internally m is to n ratio, then P far by E mx2 plus n x1 by m plus m y2 plus n y1 by m plus. This point P divides this line segment into m is to n ratio. P is A comma 0. Here m plus n value are to find. M into this is x1 y1. This is x2 y1. M x2 means 2 plus n x1. N is n. X1 means minus. By m plus n. M y2. M into y2. Y2 is minus 4. Plus n y1 means 6. By m. This is equivalent to A comma. Here A x coordinate, y coordinate is 0. That's why y equivalent to 5. 0 equal minus 4m plus 6n by m plus n. 0 equal minus 4m plus 6n. This minus 4m is equal to left side. That is plus 4m equals 2, 2, 2, 3. Here m by n, this m is left side here, multiply term, shift to the side, divide D. N, this 2 shift right side, this is multiply term, shift to the side, divide D. 3. Therefore, M is N ratio E, 3 is N B. Next one. P A by 2, 4 is the midpoint of the line segment joining the points A minus 6 comma 5 and B is minus 2 comma 3. Then the value of A is, here B is midpoint of the line segment AB. This is AB. This point B is midpoint. That point is K by 4 comma 4. This is minus 6 comma 5 minus 2 comma 3. Midpoint formula X1 plus X2 by 2. This is X1 comma Y1. This is X2 comma Y2. Now formula midpoint B is X1 plus X2 by 2. Y1 plus Y2 by 2. P point is A by 4 comma 4. What is that? X1 is minus 6. X2 is minus 2. Y1 is 5. Y2 is 3. A by 4 comma 4 is what? Minus 6 minus 2 minus 8. Y2 minus 4. 5 plus 3 8. 8 by 2 is 4. Equalizing 4 4 equal, get K by 4 equal minus. That implies K equal 4 into minus 4 is minus 6. That is K equal to minus 16. Here is K by 2. Two into minus four is minus 6. And this point is K by 2, not K by 4. Then K is minus 8. Option C. Sixth one. The coordinates of the point which divides the light segment joining P minus 2 comma 2 Q 2 comma 8 into 2 equal parts. Equal parts. Now, previously midpoint is given, we have to find the K value. This is midpoint, we have to find. That point A is divides this PQ line segment. This is PQ. This is, you have to find out A. This A is divides this line segment into two equal parts. That's why A is the midpoint of P. Then X1 plus X2 by 2, Y1 plus Y2 by 2. Here this P is minus 2 comma 2, Q is 2 comma 8. This is X1, Y1, X2, Y2. Then A is the midpoint of that line, X1 plus X2, minus 2 plus 2 by 2, Y1, 2 plus 8 by 2. Then this is 0 by 2, 0. 8 plus 10 by 2 is 5. 0 comma 5. Option C. Thank you.